he, thank God, no longer lives there. But so my brother and I just happened to go to an art show in Arlington, and we were like, oh my God, we're in Arlington, we should go see Tatum. And so we called him, and we were like, hey, we're in Arlington, we don't remember where you live though, but we want to come say hi. But he hadn't answered, we just left a voicemail. And then my brother was like, I think I do remember where he lives, we should just go. So we went and knocked on the door. He was clearly not home. And then my brother was like, his window's unlocked. It's like one of those porches where it's like the door and then there's the window. And he's just like, his window's unlocked. Do you want to go outside? And I'm like, yeah. So we take off the screen. And bear in mind, this is the crappy neighborhood that he lived in. We're like on his front porch, taking off the screen, and then like open the window, we go in, and we're like, okay, what do we do? So we rearranged his furniture and like found like post-it notes, and we wrote like notes in his, he has like a huge library because Tatum reads like a mofo, and so he has like a big like bookcases of books and whatever. And so we found like post-it notes, and we're writing like notes on the post-it notes in, to like put in his books to find later. They're like notes just like, thanks, had a great time. And then we were like, I guess we should probably go because maybe somebody called the cops by now. And then we leave and we're like driving away, and my brother's like, really want to do more stuff. And I was like, yeah, me too. So we went to a 7-Eleven up the road, and we found like, we were trying to think of like what would never be in his fridge. And so we got like mini cans, like a 6-pack of mini beers, like Miller Lite or something. got those, and then I was like, well, we should get him something nice too. So I know his favorite ice cream is Bluebell. Do you guys have Bluebell here? As a Southern thing. So you do have it here. So Bluebell homemade vanilla ice cream is his favorite. And so I got him like a little pint of that. And then when we got there, I wanted to write I Heart Tatum on it. But because of the condensation on the thing, it came out like a serial killer stabbing. Like, it was like it looked like someone carved it in, and I was like, like, and the heart was all like jagged, like, and it's like all in caps, like Tatum. And then put it in his fridge, and then we left. And probably like 45 minutes later, he calls, and he's like, "Hey, did you and Gina happen to stop by the house?" And I was like, nah, man. Like, remember I said on the voicemail we didn't remember where you lived. We wanted to stop by. I'm sad we missed you. And he's like, yeah, I think somebody broke into our house. I was like, oh my God, that's so messed up. And he's like, yeah, I gotta get to the bottom of this. And then I hang up the phone. And I fully intended on calling him back. Like after like 5 minutes or something, and just let him sweat it for a little while. But I was watching Battlestar Galactica, and I totally forgot. And I don't remember, it was somewhere between 45 minutes later or 2 hours later. I lost the sense of time. And I was like, oh my God, I should call Tatum. And so I called him back. And I was like, hey, I know you said your place was broken into. Did they leave beer and ice cream in your fridge? And he was like, oh my God, yes. And I said, they came to my house too. And then I couldn't hold it anymore because he freaked out and I started laughing. And I was like, I'm just kidding, it was me the whole time. And he was like, that's so funny because I filed a police report. just like, yeah, are you sure this isn't just someone that knows you? I mean, they didn't take anything. They obviously know your name because of this clearly serial killer handwriting. Sure it's not just somebody goofing with you. He's like, no, everyone swears it's not them. My friends would lie to me. So, yeah. So ever since then, so this goes back to the con story. So ever since then, he had vowed to get me back for years. And so we were finally going to a convention together for like the first time at Anime Central in Chicago, or Rosemont, I guess, outside of Chicago. And he had dropped hints that he was gonna get me back at this con, and I was like, all right. And so I did a preemptive strike, and you know, the American way. Wow, just got political. Preemptive strike, I contacted con, and I told them that I wanted to sing at opening ceremonies, but I needed Tatum to be on stage with me. And so they don't tell Tatum, no one tells Tatum. He gets announced right before me, and then I go on and I bring him back on stage, and I proceed to sing a version of Send in the Clowns by Stephen Sondheim, but I changed all the lyrics to be about him because he's terrified of clowns. I'm not a monster. I didn't have any clowns show up. Not a monster, but I did change all the lyrics of the song to be about him and how when I broke into his house that I brought clowns with me and that they're still there and they watch him sleep and that they'll one day turn him into one of them. And you can actually find this on YouTube. I think if you Google, probably if you Google my name and ASEN opening ceremonies, you can find it. But that's, but the best part of all of that is that he still didn't get me back after that, so now I'm just a bully. And everyone keeps asking me if I'm gonna prank him again, but I'm like, I can't. He has to prank me first. Like, I can't just continually prank him because then that's mean. It's gotta be like, it's gotta go both ways. Yeah, no, he's definitely not doing it because he doesn't want me to prank him again. And I've sort of asked him, I'm like, dude, you should prank me. And he's like, no. I'm like, why not? Because then you'll prank me again. I'm like, yeah, it's fun.
I think there's a video of like one of his old panels where he tells the story from his perspective.
Yes, that's actually my favorite thing in the world is whenever we are on a panel together and we both get to tell the story.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's pretty fun.
Right. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Too, or did you just want to tell me how awesome I am?
Yeah, pretty much.
Okay, I'll take it.
My name is Taylor, and I just wanted to know if any of the characters that you voice acted as inspired you or helped you in any way with anything?
Oh, wow, what a good question.
Thank you.
Yeah, any of the characters have ever inspired me or helped me in any way. Yeah, I mean, I definitely, anytime you take on a role, it's a part of you, like it's a part of yourself that you're bringing to the role. So, I mean, you do always kind of have to ask yourself, like, all right, if I'm playing all of these dark and brooding characters all the time, what does that say about me? I don't know that I could think of any specific ones. I mean, I know, like, Ciel was a really important, has been a really important role for me just in life, just because I care about that role so much. And I know that for Book of Circus, how many of you guys have seen Book of Circus? Thank you. I loved Book of Circus. It's my favorite arc of anything Black Butler related. And it was also the hardest and like literally most painful ones to record because I had a hole in my eardrum at the time, and it was right before I went to surgery for it. And so I was like, like to scream, and he screams a lot in that one, to scream, even just calling things out, even just hearing myself in the headphones was like really painful. Mm-hmm. And I had really bad tinnitus throughout it as well. So it was like, I genuinely felt like I was losing my mind the whole time. Like just in my personal life, like it really was like, I was going through really severe depression myself and like anxiety at the time. So like going through that role was, I honestly didn't know if I could do it. I really didn't know if I could do it. But because I did and I got through it and I am really proud of that, it did help me know that I was stronger than I thought I was, so.
Do you mind if I give you something?
What's that?
I have a note for you.
Okay. Yay. Should I read it out loud? I'm just kidding. Thank you. Thank you so much. You guys are all so sweet.
Hi, my name's Julia. I was wondering if you could do a voice impression of Yuno.
Of Yuno?
Yeah.
Time for peepees.
Also, what's it like to voice someone as crazy as Yuno?
Man, you know, it's really fun. Like, I mean, it's so fun to voice somebody. For me, it's much more fun to voice someone who is crazy if I know why. It's like what I said before. Because they did such a good job with her backstory and they did such a good job justifying her actions emotionally, it was a blast. I loved it. It was so fun.
Thank you.
Can you still do your Nina Tucker voice from 2004?
Oh my gosh! Nina Tucker, no one's asked me to do that one in a long time. Yeah, I can still do that, I think.
Can you say, "It's okay, Papa, I still love you"?
Yeah, I know I'm evil.
It's okay, Papa, I still love you.
Thank you. Oh, yes. Because you look fabulous. Oh, also, just for the record, for all of you Book of Circus lovers, I totally shipped Dawn and Ciel. So hard.
But can you say, "Nice try, Kim, but I'm still better," in Ciel's voice?
"Nice try, Kim, but I'm still better."
Thank you so much.
Hey, Jennifer.
Doing pretty good, how are you?
Good.
Join the con?
Yeah.
Good.
Thanks.
How many cons have you been to? Is this your first one?
No, well, I've been here twice, but...
You've been here twice? Yeah. That's dope. Is this your second time to any con?
Yes. And it's the best one because you guys are better.
Yeah, obviously.
So, my name is Roberto, or Mr. Ruff. I was wondering, for anime characters, my favorite ones for me personally are Rei from Evangelion and Yin from Dark and Black.
Yeah.
I was wondering if you have any preference over the two, or like if you, which one do you think you can relate to more?
Between Yin and Rei? Oh, that's a good question. I think probably Yin, because with Rei I only got to do the movies, so I didn't get to do a full series. So I didn't spend that many hours in the booth with her. Like total, with all the movies that I did, it was like 3, I think. Yeah, I probably spent 3 hours. Whereas with Yin, I probably spent more, like closer to 20, you know what I mean? So I spent more time with Yin, so just as a product of that, I probably feel closer to her.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thanks.
Hello, and thank you for coming. coming to Anime Boston.
Thank you for coming to Anime Boston.
Thanks. My name is Chris, and I have one question. Although, I want to say thank you for voicing Chopper in the Funimation dub of One Piece. You helped save a great anime.
Thanks.
And the question I have for you is, what was your favorite character to voice in a drama? In a drama. Like, anime drama.
Favorite character to voice in an anime drama?
Yeah.
I mean, Ciel, probably.
Ciel?
Yeah.
I liked you as Holo.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's weird to think of that as a drama. Because I'm like, in comparison to Black Butler, because Black Butler is so dark.
Oh, yeah.
It's so dramatic. Yeah, Holo's awesome, too. I love Holo. I also love Yuno. I love Natsuki in Summer Wars is another one that means a lot to me. Maho and Beck, I loved her.
That's a good anime.
Yeah, it is. If you guys haven't seen Beck, you should watch it. It's all about like the music scene in Tokyo. It's awesome.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Bridget. I met you yesterday. I was just as Mayrin. This is my natural hair color. I have two questions. One. Can you ask Sebastian to get tea in the Ciel voice?
She's my Sebastian. Sebastian, get me my tea. No, thank you. You already did it.
Also, what do you think Ciel actually thinks of his servants?
I don't think he does. Like, truly, I really don't think he even thinks of them. I don't think he learned that. Like, because he went from having a family to not, to just be surrounded by servants who are not teaching him empathy. Like, he's not learning how to take care of other people or think of other people at all. Like, he's literally surrounded by people who serve him. And I don't think he knows how.
Also, an extension of that, do you think the servants know that Sebastian's a butler? I mean, a demon, sorry.
Yes, I do think that.
Okay.
I don't know if they do, but I do think they know.
You just solved, like, a two-month-long debate.
I mean, I'm not the definitive person. You gotta ask the freaking writer. I don't know. You have awesome!
Hi, my name is Kara. That was actually my sister.
Sister, sister.
Did anybody watch that show ever?
Yeah. Yeah, I loved you in Fairy Tale as Juvia. She's like, Lucy's my favorite character, but I love Juvia as well, and I also love you, know?
Clearly.
Yeah. So my question.
Nice knife.
Oh, thanks. I gotta protect Yuki at all costs, you know?
Yeah, totally.
So my question is, what do you think would happen if Juvia and Yuno met?
No one has ever asked me that, and it shocks me that. I think they would be best friends. I really do. I think they could be really good for each other. Yeah. I did finally find that kindred spirit, and they're not in love with, if they were in love with the same boy, then
woo!
That's a lot of love. But yeah, no, because they're in love with two totally different guys, completely, and types of guys too, like totally different. Like, man, I think they would be best friends. I really do. What a great idea. Somebody make the fanfic of that or something. Yes.
Thank you.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yes, my name is Nathan. I was wondering, you mentioned in your sing-along or concert yesterday that you felt, well, that you were part of Endurement.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, how does it generally feel to be a foreigner to both the United States and Honduras?
I love this question so much. So, being Honduran, my father is Honduran, my mom is American. I grew up in both countries. And I have to be honest, I never felt welcomed in either one. I always felt that I was kind of in limbo, like in Honduras, I was always seen as the American kid, and then here I was always seen as a Honduran kid. And it was really hard. And to be honest, and I'm not saying that he was a perfect president, but it wasn't until Barack Obama was in office that I actually felt like I was allowed to say I was American.
Another thing I wanted to ask, is it okay if you and I have a conversation with Ciel and Sebastian?
Ciel and Sebastian?
Yeah.
Sure. But I do want to add something to that. I think that's why, that's something to remember right now, because I do feel like a shift in our politics against sort of what is being defined as American, whereas I feel like when Barack Obama was in office, the one thing that he did that was really good was that diversity is what makes us great. And I hope that that can continue, although I know that there are some that would disagree with me that they don't want that to continue, but I think that is what makes America great, is our diversity. And I just hope that we can all remember that and that we can all support each other in that, because there are a lot of us here. I mean, luckily for me, I get to pass as, like, I look white as hell. So, like, I mean, most people don't know that I'm Honduran. I mean, I'll get the occasional, like, what are you? But there are people of color that, like, are not seen as American right now, that are just not treated as being a part of this great country that they also love. Like, I don't think, like, I can't express to you how important it is when you've grown up in a third world country and you come to the United States and seeing the difference of what it is. Like, I love America so much. I love this country so much because I know what the alternative is. And you are not gonna get a more faithful citizen than someone who has been able to escape a much more difficult way of life. That's it. So, yeah, I did not expect to go there today, but I'm glad that I got to. Thank you. So, you want to have a conversation? That is like the two opposite spectrums of questions. Like, let's get political and now let's talk.
Good afternoon, Ciel.
Good afternoon.
Today, you have something in your schedule, a dance lesson followed by a violin lesson, not to mention that you must also do the rounds of the Queen's Chamber.
Right, so when do I get my cookie?
Unfortunately, you are not allowed to have sweets until you complete your mission. These are the Queen's orders. You are her watchdog, of course.
What about cake? Can I have cake?
That would depend on what is available on our journey.
Right, well, keep an eye out.
Will do.
Thank
As
you,
always,
sir.
I serve you.
Can you say Chopper's reaction to his outfit when he stands up? Or did he?
That's so cute!
Hello! You're like an explosion of America.
I am from America, of course.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm Kristen, and this is like completely away from anime. I just wanted to know what your favorite Beatles song was.
My favorite Beatles song? Oh, that's so hard. I was actually named after Michelle Mybelle. My middle name is Michelle.
Oh.
So that song has a lot of meaning to me. Also, if you guys like that song, Michelle Mybelle, this is a choir nerd moment. How many of you are familiar with the Kingsingers? Look them up, y'all, because they're real good. It's an a cappella group from the UK, and they've been around for generations. And they do some really, really killer arrangements of a cappella arrangements of stuff, and they have an arrangement of Michelle Mybelle that I actually cried. The first time that I heard it, I was like, it's so beautiful. But they have a whole album. If you're a choir nerd and a Beatles nerd, you will never be happier. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Dominique. No, I'm
feel like that's my favorite show. I wish J-Michael Tatum was here because this would have been much better, but can you do a love
question? Wait, did you just say if Tatum was here, it would be better than
no,
if I was here?
No. so
you needed both of those, right?
Yeah, so there would be a response between the two.
Yes. Because
I wanted to see this in person and all that, and I got so excited that you were here. But can you do a love confession from Ciel to Sebastian?
That's a complicated one, because I don't disagree that there is something there. I don't think it comes from Sebastian at all, but I do think that Ciel, it's easy to have that confusion as a boy, like just as far as like his whole backstory, it's easy to not understand what your feelings are for this being, the one being that you've been able to count on ever, and the one being that's always there for you. And who's also really cool. So I guess, I don't know that, I'm trying to think of how to do that in a way that I think would honor the character. Because I don't think it's completely far-fetched.
Because I've seen the one where, when you two were doing a panel together, J. Michael Tatum came up and he proposed to Ciel. And then you're like, will you still be my butler? And he's like, yeah, of course. He goes, then yes.
Yeah.
Because I've seen that one.
Yeah, that was a long time ago. Yeah, I'm trying to think of the best way to say it.
Sebastian. I just want you to know. I hope that you're with me my whole life.
Because I love you! And then Sebastian's like, cool, can I eat your soul though? Like when you're dead? Because that's all I care about.
Also, are you also really excited for the new, for the Black Butler movie, Book of Atlantic?
Yeah!
I'm like so excited for that. And also, can you do your cheating tally voice? Chibitalia reciting one of Ciel's lines.
Oh my gosh! What a good one! Chibitalia saying a Ciel line.
Anyone?
Hey! I think that I will never let go of my hatred!
Beautiful, thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. You're great in Ciel, and you're awesome. Juvia from Fairy Tale, but the first time I heard you was from School Rumble.
So, how many School Rumble fans are here?
Yay! School Rumble's my baby! I directed that show.
Oh, yeah, this is awesome. What's your favorite School Rumble moment?
Oh my god, there's so many good moments. I really want to go back and rewatch it. Gosh, I did that show over 10 years ago. Was it? No, it was 10 years ago, almost exactly. God, that was such a fun show. Pretty much anything that Hari Mendel is hilarious to me. I think Brandon Potter totally killed it. I'm trying to think. I really liked Hanai and the moments that Hanai and Makoto had together, where you could really see their friendship, like when it kind of reveals that they like grew up together and that they were in the same dojo together. I love that stuff. I love the stuff between Harry and Makoto, like when they kind of bonded as well. I loved the Battle Royale spoof that they did in season 2. That was so much fun to direct because it was just so overly dramatic and just like, oh, it was so fun. Seriously, guys, watch School Rumble if you haven't. It's so much fun and we put so much of our heart and soul into that. Like, oh my gosh. Yeah, I loved that show.
It was one of my favorites. I was like, yes.
Yeah.
So much when I first watched it.
Yeah, good choice. Super fun. I use the phrase pansy core a lot in that show. And this is a spoiler, so if you haven't seen Black Butler, like, close your ears. In season 1, my favorite scene is when he is confronted with his parents, and they try to get him to go with him, and that's when he says the whole, like, I will never let go of my hatred. Like, that whole thing, like, I I lost my mind on that scene. I love that scene. In season two, I loved it when he was possessed by Aloise, because it was just really fun. The way that we recorded that was Lucy came in and recorded all those lines first, and then I would, like, instead of watching the Japanese do it, I would watch her do it and then come in and do it just to kind of have her cadence, which was really cool. And then in season three, and probably my favorite moment of all, was the very end. When, and this is also a spoiler, when they go to where that orphanage is supposed to be, and when he just loses it, and that whole monologue, which I wish I had memorized. I need to memorize it so I can do it at conventions. It's so brutal, and so it's so sad. Like, there's so much going on, because he's laughing hysterically, but he's also heartbroken, but he's also like, everything is meaningless. Like, to just going through all of that in your brain, especially when you're only 13, like, it's so much. So honestly, doing that monologue was probably, that was one of my favorite acting moments, period. Like, not just in Black Butler, not just in anime, but just period. That was one of my favorites.
And my second question is, what do you think you'd do if you could meet Ciel? Like, if you were, like, a physical person?
What would I do if I met Ciel?
Yeah.
In life? I would hug him so hard. Like, because he's so sad. Like, especially at the end of, by the end of Book of Murder, maybe? It was the end of Book of Circus. Ian pointed out that in between every take, I looked like someone had shot my puppy. Like, I just looked so sad. Because it's so devastating, like, to see him lose grip. Like, he loses his touch with humanity. Like, he doesn't, I mean, because at every turn, he's shown the wrong thing. Like, he's shown the bad sides. Like, he doesn't, there's no light in his life. So it's like, how is he supposed to react any differently? It's so sad to me. I would just want to give him a hug and take him to Disneyland or something.
Thank you, have a good day. My name is Jenna, and I wanted to know how you felt about voicing as Chopper.
How I feel about voicing Chopper? Great every time. I think he's the cutest character that I've ever gotten to play, for sure.
I love Chopper.
Yeah, me too.
I also wanted to ask how you would view my Ciel voice that I've been working on for 3 years.
If I could hear yours?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry if I really suck. Sebastian, please promote death.
I do that all the time on the mic, actually.
Sebastian, prepare a boat to sail.
That's like a very sexy version, actually. Just like a little sultry in there, actually.
You staying later again for the signatures.
Yeah.
I also actually had a couple part question. Talking about like how you had like brought something away from the character you voiced as, and like maybe a connection you had with the character. I was actually wondering what you had with Mad Moxie from Borderlands.
Oh man, Moxie was a cool journey because I didn't understand why I was cast. At first, because you know, she doesn't, the first time she comes in is the DLC,
yeah.
And so I at that time had never played a sexy role at all, and so when I did the audition, I was like, okay, I'll just whatever do that, never gonna happen. And the audition for the other character is cool, and then my agent called and they're like, hey, you got cast in Borderlands, dope, which character? And they were like, oh, it looks like Mad Moxie, and I laughed, and I was like, that's not accurate. I'm sure I'll find out when I get there what it actually is. And then I get there, and they're like, oh yeah, you're doing Mad Moxie. And I was like, okay, we'll see. Like, because in my mind, I was like, they're going to fire me. Like, there's no way that I'm going to get this. Like, they're going to see that I'm incapable of this, and they will get someone else. And they didn't. And I did it, and it was really, really, really hard. Because I usually, you know, I'm not, when I go in to record, it usually doesn't take me very long. Like, I usually understand the character real quickly, and then I can just knock it out super fast, just like one or two takes each line, and done. Whereas with Moxie, it was like, especially in the beginning, it was like 4 or 5 takes, like, each time, and I'm like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, I'm definitely gonna get fired. Thankfully, they did not fire me, and then by the time the sequel came out, and the, she's been in the pre-sequel too, right? I don't play the game, so I don't remember which one she's in, and we record everything at the same time, so whatever. The stuff where she's in it a lot again. Anthony Birch did an amazing job of giving her a lot of depth, and like, she was really funny, and like, kind of knowing that backstory of her, that she used to be a ho-dunk, and then like, got out and everything with her kids and all that, was pretty cool. Like, I liked having that depth of character. It gave me something as an actor to latch on to, rather than just like, say a sexy innuendo, and like, that's all you do. So it helped having that character build, and it then became really, really fun. Like, I went from being terrified every time I went into the booth, I'm like, they're gonna fire me, they're gonna fire me, they're gonna fire me, they're gonna fire me, to where now it's like, this is really fun, this is cool. So I hope I get to be in the third one. Yeah. They haven't started, I don't think they've started recording yet, but I hope that I'm in that, because I really want to do more of that.
Okay, yeah, I was actually gonna ask you that too, if you had been contacted or anything, if they...
Not yet.
Just one last thing. Do you mind doing your favorite Mad Nazi line?
Oh, man. I won't do it justice, but there's that one where she's talking about... I'll never forget what Jim Hodunk said to me when I left that something clan forever. Damn, hold on! I want to look it up! Because it's so good. I think I wrote it down once for this very occasion. Because I can never... I'm one of those people that I memorize super, super fast, and then the second that I don't need to know it anymore, I forget it immediately.
Yeah.
Like, I can memorize a monologue in a day, and then I'll perform it, and then the next day, I don't need it.
Life of an actor.
What?
Life of an actor. Life of an actor kind of thing. Like, you know, you have to memorize it really quickly, and then after a while, it's like...
Yeah, totally. Oh my god, I will never find this. Oh, why don't I just freaking Google Moxie lines? Duh. If I ever use the internet, Moxie best lines. Also, this is, I'm sorry, this is actually, I'm the reason that this is taking so long. Oh my god. The world is ending. Here's a good one. Well, hello. Don't just stand there looking gorgeous. The drinks don't cost much, but information's a bit pricier. It's not nearly as funny as the one I was looking for. All right, lightning round, we got 5 minutes.
Okay. Hi, my name is Peterson. I'm a voiceover geek, and you're the first voice actor I've ever met, so thank you for your work. I was wondering, could Chopper and Juvia have a conversation?
Hey, Juvia. I think you need help.
What do you mean?
I think, you're insane, and you should probably, maybe, I don't know, be locked up?
How dare you!
No, I mean, I'm just saying, as a member of the medical profession, maybe just, like, see a psychologist?
Well, I mean, you are very cute.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Elise, and the little one that came up earlier, Angela, in the Black Wig, that was my little sister. She wanted me, well, first I'm gonna ask this one, this is my question. What is your favorite dub of anime, anyone?
My favorite what?
Anime dub, anyone you like.
That I watch?
Yeah.
Or that I'm in?
Most likely watch, like.
That I watch. Hellsing.
Ah. So they wanted my friends. They wanted me to ask you to sing Happy Birthday in Ciel's voice.
To who? Is it
everyone?
Birthday? Whose birthday is it? All right,
it's everyone's birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Anime Boston. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
How's it going?
Live the dream.
Yes, exactly. My name is Mike, and I had a quick question. So, if you think that Juvia could use a cat companion in Fairy Tail, who do you think would be her best companion? And then, if you yourself in real life had to have a cat companion from Fairy Tail, who would you personally pick?
A cat companion?
Yeah, in the actual series.
Can I have my cat? I have two great cats. They can't fly. My cat, Sherbert. Okay, so I think Juvia would benefit from my cat, Sherbert. He's the orange one. And then in real life, oh, I can't choose between Sherbert and Morty. I mean, if Juvia's gonna take Sherbert, I guess I'll take Morty.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hello.
Hello.
My name is Flavio, and what was it like voicing the character of the Yuze and Cashman Sins?
The Yuze and Cashman Sins was awesome. I love the way that it was animated. I think Eric did an amazing job as Casher. And but no one ever watched it.
Well, I did.
The only one, yeah. But yeah, you guys should watch Casher and Sins. It's dope.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Hello.
You guys look awesome.
Thank you. I was wondering, what was the best part of voicing this crazy girlfriend?
The best part of, as I said before, just the fact that they took the time to actually flesh out the character meant everything. Also, the ending, holy smokes, brain explosion. I mean, I knew that it was coming because that's one of those things that as an actor, you need to know ahead of time just so you know where your character's headspace is. When I signed on to do it and they told me what the ending was, I was like, what? That's so awesome. So if you guys haven't finished Future Diary, finish it, because it's so worth it.
Can we hear Yuno say Yuki?
Yuki!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, my name's Yuno. Was there any characters that you wanted to voice but didn't get to? And what voices would you use for them?
With an actor, there are literally thousands that I auditioned for that would have been cool to do that I didn't do. But because emotionally I have to move on so quickly, much like my lines, I don't remember any of them.
My name is Jacqueline.
This is going to be the best question of all time because you're the last one.
But you wrote Jack-O-Lantern.
Was I a Jack-O-Lantern?
No, you wrote Jack-O-Lantern in my notebook yesterday.
I wrote Jack-O-Lantern on your thing. That's right, because I said, yeah. I just
back two questions. Was it awkward for you to voice the corset scene for Ciel?
Yes.
My second question was, if you were to cosplay one of your, the characters that you voice, who would you cosplay as?
I have already cosplayed as my character in Summer Wars, Natsuki in Summer Wars. I cosplayed as her, and I Monica Rial and I both Monica went all out with Mei Rin, and I kind of cosplayed Ciel. I didn't have the wig, but I have the whole getup or whatever, and my whole hat. I want to do a cosplay of Ciel from Book of Circus as Smile. I want to do Smile. If you know any cosplayers that want to make me a costume, let me know.
Great, thank you.
Okay, that's me. Kiki, did you have anything you wanted to add?
And that's it.